So I've got the project loaded up in Notepad. If I open it up briefly in the browser to remind myself what it looked like, 2 days ago was a long time. I'm going to look what we've got here. So random names. We've got a form where we can enter a name. We're doing full name. This can be, of course, set up for last name, first name, birthdays, whatever. And I'm going to put in a name. That's going the opposite way, maybe. Nope. Okay. So I'm going to save that. Just saving some names. Show the names. They show up. Hide the names. Show the names. Delete the names. Confirm. Cancel. Confirm. OK. They go away. I saw slightly different behavior, interestingly, in Chrome. If you run the program in Chrome, it's very subtle. It doesn't quite matter, but this goes into the differences between each browser. If I put in some information, and I'm in Chrome at the moment, I'm saving different names, show those, I click delete and click OK. There's a moment where that is not cleared out on screen, but it has said the names have been cleared out. Once I click OK, it then goes away. Slightly different in Firefox. I add names, show all, delete, click OK, and it has deleted it actually first before showing that pop-up, because technically in the code that's how we have it. Clear the div, then do the pop-up, then proceed. For some reason it seems that there might be some precedence or something in Chrome where it did the pop-up first, then clear the div, and then after you close the pop-up, the div clears. Things like that, those little idiosyncrasies, those are the different web browsers and the different platforms interpreting the HTML and the CSS and JavaScript in their own slight ways. It's like dialects. We may all speak English, but maybe I speak with an American accent or a British accent or a South African accent. It's all English, but it's a different dialect. HTML, it's all HTML, but each browser then interprets it and has its own dialect, and I just noticed that on Chrome. There's ways to kind of fix that up with other libraries that are supposed to take care of these inconsistencies. Nothing to really worry about at the moment, just something I noticed. What I want to start to do then is, based on our example, I then want to pull up random instances of the names. I want to pull a name from the list of in the array randomly, and then I want to display all the names randomly. Getting back to our Notepad, we need a couple of buttons on screen to also have that functionality. Let's go back to our form block. So starting on line 9, where our form begins, we see the input fields. Some of them are boxes, some of them are buttons. We're going to do another HR to divide on screen the different elements visually. So in HR, after the show all, hide all, and delete HR, we'll create two new buttons. Input type of button, value, the text that appears on screen. We'll say get one, random, with an ID, so we can reference it in the JavaScript, btn random one. And then another input type button. You can copy and paste and just change a couple of things, or get practice, get all random. btn random all. I'm calling then these particular IDs this thing is a button, like prefix them with BTNs, and then some unique name that can hopefully tell me what that button is or what it should do at a glance. If I call it my button, well, it has no meaning at all. Yeah, it's your button, it's your app. But BTN or button random all, that kind of tells me this might be a button to get all of them randomly. BTN random one sort of tells me this is a button to perhaps get one random name out of the array. BTN delete all. Well, that makes sense out of context. If it was ID equals my button, that makes no sense out of context. When I often teach these HTML and CSS and JavaScript classes, I also mention here and there that part of writing a good program, we're writing a program, we're programmers. Part of writing a good program is not only writing the code properly, but perhaps writing the code beautifully, writing the code interestingly or nice looking. That is completely optional and for aesthetics, but I like to do it, I like to teach this. What I mean is, all of this works just fine. But perhaps for aesthetics, I could add a few empty spaces simply to line up some of these things, spaces or tabs. That'll work exactly the same as before, but I'm only doing that because I think that looks nice. There's an imaginary column here, and here, and here. I could do it with other elements as well. And when we get to the JavaScript, when we're creating a lot of variables at once, and when we're adding comments, I like to line things up in this sort of way. I like to tab. Usually a tab works better than a bunch of spaces. And I like to tab and line things up. Completely optional for you to do. But I think, and many others also think, good code is functional code as well as beautiful code. And even just simple things like this for organization, this adds to the beauty of the code itself. Functionality-wise, nothing important there, but visually, I think it's important. If I check this in the browser, this should create a few more buttons that don't do anything yet, of course, until we program them. Did the sign-in sheet go around? Did everyone get that sign-in sheet? Did everyone get the roster sign? Okay, so for these buttons to work, we need something that triggers them to work. So we'll do the same as the document.getElementById, referencing, we'll start with the getOneRandom first. It will most likely call a function, which is a series of steps. And then we'll see what those steps are. So we've got the pair for the name save. We've got the pair for the show all. And what I mean with pair is the event handler. This handles the event of a click. And then the function definition. I would consider that a pair. Hide all, delete all. After end of delete all, document.getElement, we need to activate the getOne button, btnRandom1, right, that was the RID for that. Dot on click equals some function that we'll make up, and we'll call it fn show random one. We need to define that function, so right after it, function show random one. Close parentheses, curly braces, and that's end fn random one. this activates or sort of prepares the button to do something in Event Handler, and then the function that we invoke after a click. We saw that plenty of times last time. My idea here is that we need to look inside of the array and from our possible names saved in the array, we need to then retrieve one randomly. We're going to introduce random numbers. We can generate random numbers to have us pick one of them from the array. First, what I want to do inside of the function, define a variable which will be to temporarily store how many names are currently in the array. That'll definitely change. That'll definitely vary. I may add three names, and then let's retrieve one. Then I add three more names. So now I've got six to choose from. Let's retrieve one. I add 30 more. Now I've got 36 names to choose from. So this is why we definitely need a variable here. We need to check how many names are there at this point in time. I'm going to call this namelen equals allNames.length. AllNames is the name of the global variable we created early on, which stores all of the names we're saving one at a time. And at this point, we're checking the length. We're checking how many names